Hello, now we've converted the IKEA air quality sensor and the IKEA air filter. In this video, we'll update the code on the air quality sensor to automatically control the speed of the air filter. So here's a little demo. I've got my studio unit here and my window sensor, and they're both sitting on the IKEA air filter. Also on my desktop, we've got the fan speed for the IKEA fan. And over here, we've got the air quality sensor itself. And I'm going to demonstrate how the particle count governs the speed of the air filter. So first of all, I've got a little smoke machine here, so I'm going to put some smoke in the air and we'll watch the particle count go up. As you can see, the particle count has gone right up, and because it's over our 400 max threshold, that fan speed is now speed 6. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to open a window, put a big fan on just to clear the smoke out of this room, and we can watch the particle count go down as well as the fan speed go down as well. Another thing we can do, if I mimic the window being open by opening up that sensor, you'll see now that the fan's gone off. And if I close the window again, this is my automation trigger. We can see now the fan's come back on again. Okay, let's open a window, clear this off, and then I can do a time lapse so you don't have to wait. So there you go. As the particle count went down, you can see that the air filter speed also decreased until the particle count got below 40, at which point the fan turned itself off. Next up, I'll show you how to update your air quality code, and I'll also run you through the code with all the extra bits that I've added and how the automation works. Okay, let's update the code. I'm going to update this one, which is my office air quality sensor. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy out a few things from here so that my code remains the same. So we'll have the substitutions, the ESPHome name, and then we'll scroll down and we'll grab the baseline from there because we're going to need that because our sensor is calibrated. Next, we'll go to my GitHub page. I've added the V2 code for ESPHome. So we'll click on that. We'll go to copy raw file. So I'll copy that into the clipboard of my computer. Go back to ESPHome. I'm going to select all, control A, then I'm going to control V to copy in the new code. And now we want to put our names back in. So substitution name, copy that, put that in there. ESPHome name, copy that, replace that. And then our baseline, take that calibration baseline and put it into the CO2 and VOC sensor. That way the calibration carries across. Next, we want to fill in these two entity IDs. So first of all is the air purifier ID. I'm going to be controlling my studio air filter. So that's a slider. So we're going to pick up the studio air filter speed. As you can see, that's the slider from 0 to 6. So we'll grab that entity ID from there and we'll just paste that. And then we want the auto enable. Now I'm using my window here. This can be any entity in Home Assistant. So you could have a helper for like a binary sensor or maybe a switch that you use to turn off the automation here. So that one's called bedroom window binary sensor. So I'm going to copy that and we'll just paste that into there. And then we'll save that. Control S. There's also three more substitutions here. We've got the air filter speeds. And if you've also made the IKEA air filter, as you remember, a air filter has 6 speeds. So we put a 6 in there. You can also use this with any other fan, like my 3-speed fan project. Obviously that's 3 speeds. So you put a 3 in there. Next up is the PMS low or particle count low. This is the value that the automation will turn off the fan. And then finally, PMS high, as it says here, this is the particle count at which point the fan will be at its max speed. So in this case, 6. Other additions to the code, I've added a new binary sensor, and this takes the auto enable, you'll see that up here, auto enable. And again, that's my binary sensor for my window. And I've given it an ID so I can reference this sensor elsewhere in the code as enable automation. That enable binary sensor comes into the next bit of code that I've added, which is the on value for the particle sensor. So here we have the enable automation. Now for a window sensor, when the window is closed, and obviously that's when I want the air filters to run, when the window is closed, this binary sensor is off. So I've done binary sensor is off. Now if you're using a switch, you would say something like switch is on if you want the automation to run. So on value, if this condition is true, i.e. my window's closed and the binary sensor is off, then it's going to do something. What we're going to do is a Home Assistant service, the service being number set value, and that's going to set the value of the slider that's controlling our filter. So if I go back to number here, This set value is going to control this slider. Remember, this is a number, so number set value. And this service needs two values. So in data, we want the entity ID. Remember, that's the air purifier ID, which is this one here. And obviously that's referencing this because that's what we want to control. And we also need a value. Now for the value, we're going to work out A, if the particle count is low, in which case turn this slider to zero. And B, if the particle count is above our threshold, remember I put that at 400, we want the speed to be 6. And I've done that with a lambda. First of all, auto range, that is a variable in a lambda, and I've called this variable range, and you can see that referenced elsewhere in the code. So I'm just using auto here. What that does is that determines whether range, which is our variable name, is going to be an integer or a float. So we don't have to work out whether it's going to be an integer or float later on. We just put an auto there. So that's the same as declaring a variable of either float or integer. So the range, this part of the code here, is going to work out the value between 1 and 5. Next up, I made another variable called value, and again, we're using the auto here. Rather than doing a whole list of if, then, and else, I've combined all of that down to pretty much a single line. I'll show you how this code breaks down into if and then statements as we go along. First, we're going to do an if x. Remember that x is an internal variable for the sensor that it's attached to. If x is less than PMS low, we go back up here, PMS low is 40. So if x is less than 40, I'm going to return a zero. Shorthand for else is a colon. So if this is not true, we're going to do another if. So if this is not true, else, if, remember the question mark there, if the range, which is this variable here, is more than the number of speeds, and number of speeds here is 6. So if this range here is more than 6, so all I'm going to do is return the number of speeds. So if the range is more than 6, return 6. Else, return the range. So basically, if this is not true, then do this. If this is not true, return the range. And that's our value here. Last thing we need to do is return the variable value to the value for a number set value. And that will write the value to this slider. Also, I'm using a ceiling command here. And that's basically going to round the number up. So if this comes out as a floating point number, it's just going to round it up to the next higher value. That's when the automation is running, i.e. this condition is true. When this condition is not true, and in my case, if the window is open, rather than doing the then, we do the else. So if this condition is not true, else. And once again, we're using the Home Assistant service number set value, same as we did up here. Obviously the same air purifier ID as we used before. And this time we're just gonna set it to zero again, and that will turn off this slider. Everything else is the same, so we don't need to worry about any of that on this video. So now with all that done, I'm going to install it. Right, now that's updated and installed, we can see we've got an error now in Home Assistant. Because we're using an ESPHome device to control an entity in Home Assistant, we need to allow that device to make changes to Home Assistant. As we can see here, the ESPHome device has attempted to make a service call. The way we get around this is if we go to Devices and Services, ESPHome, scroll down to the device in question. In my case, it's the air quality sensor. And all we need to do is hit configure and then allow the device to make Home Assistant service calls. We'll just submit that, finish. We can see now the error has gone. Well, I hope this video was helpful for your projects. Please do share it so others can find it as well. I upload videos whenever I can, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Okay, I love you, Bubba.